This morning, I have a number of issues that we want to communicate to the nation. Number one, people have been asking, why is Nawakwi so incessantly attacking HH every day that her program of life now is insulting HH, calling HH names? People have been asking why. And people have been speculating. But now I have information on my table as party spokesperson of the UPND that Madam Edith Zewelani Nawakwi has entered into a pact, into a contract with the Patriotic Front to be attacking HH so that she is spared from paying on time the $3 to $4 million United States dollars that she owes Development Bank of Zambia. The information reaching this desk is that Madam Edith Zewelani Nawakwi owes Development Bank of Zambia, DBZ, $3 to $4 million. Hence, this behavior of attacking HH in order to please PF so that PF don't squeeze her, because we are told she's finding it difficult to pay back those colossal sums of money. In Zambian terms, we are being told she owes Development Bank of Zambia 88 million kwacha. When you translate it at the current rate of 22 kwacha. Round figure, Madam Nawakwi owes Development Bank of Zambia 90 million kwacha. And that because she's finding it difficult to pay back, she has entered into a political deal with the Patriotic Front to say, look, we will not squeeze you much. So you now, your job is to be harassing HH. Call HH all sorts of names, insult him, discredit him. Now, with this information that we have received, we ask Madam Nawakwi to deny that she owes Development Bank of Zambia 90 million kwacha or 3 to 4 million United States dollars that she is finding difficult to pay back, hence this entering into an unholy alliance with the Patriotic Front to attack HH and the UPND. Let her come out and tell the nation if this is not true, so that the nation can understand the morale, where she gets the morale every day. Morale, talk time, to talk about HH in the manner she does. You know, attacking someone as if she's not even a mother, because a mother should have a good heart. A mother should be a unifier. But she's the one who has been placed at the center of disunity. She doesn't even care that she will engage in contemptuous statements. She doesn't care that she will be sued the way she was sued over the so-called Lima Bank house transaction, because her paymasters, we are taught, have given her assurances, the Patriotic Front. So, Madam Nawakwi, please come out in the open. This briefing is meant to us, to give you an opportunity to respond to this information. Whether this information is true or it's not true, deny it and extricate yourself from the fact that you are failing to pay that debt. That's why you are politically conducting yourself in a manner that many citizens have been wondering what is going on in this country, what is going on in the mind of Madam Nawakwi. You remember the other day I was even saying that if Madam Edith Zewelani Nawakwi was a president, would have gone to petition the the Chief Justice to set up a medical board to inquire into the state of her mind, the sanity, whether she's still properly composed. Because recently the things she has been saying have been very worrisome. So for those who care about the welfare of other citizens, is there something here which we are not yet understanding? Now information is beginning to surface. So, redeem yourself. If you want to attack HH on moral grounds, it should be known. Don't attack HH for financial gain. Don't attack HH because you are failing to pay a debt. That my desk here as party spokesperson and as a UPND, we have received now petitions from the family of the Mazubas, the ones from whom HH bought the Kalomo farm, who they themselves had bought the farm from the Hatembos. As you know, HH did not buy that farm in issue from the Hatembos. He bought it from the Mazubas. The Mazubas are the ones who sold to HH. The only connection was and is that because they had not yet executed a title deed, then the Hatembos had to execute a title deed directly into the name of HH. The family of the Mazubas have begun to petition us as to what role they can play in this circus being played out by Madame Nawakwi over the Hatembos. And I didn't want to talk about this, but this morning, a phone call which I received touched me. Because the son to the Mazubas, who had bought that farm, called me and said, look, it would appear now Madame Nawakwi is taking advantage of the fact that my father, who had bought that farm from the Hatembos and sold it clean and clear to HH because he is dead. He can't come out to speak for himself as to how clean that transaction was. Nawakwi is exploiting this gap for political gains. They've asked me to communicate to Madame Nawakwi that they are not happy that their father, a Mr. Mazuba, who had bought the farm from the Hatembos, died, and that having this situation where he died, there is a vacuum. Nawakwi has come to fill in the vacuum to take advantage for political gain. They've asked that we do communicate to Madame Nawakwi to learn to respect the dead. Because in the words of Mr. Mazuba's son, the late Mazuba's son, who I spoke to this morning when he called me, he said, if our father was alive, this story would never have even begun. Because this transaction was beyond any question whatsoever. We have unearthed a scam in which the Patriotic Front are using the Disaster Management and Mitigation Unit, DMMU, as a focal point for vote buying. Currently, as we speak now, they have been doing this for the last 2 weeks or more. As we speak now, and I challenge you journalists to go to their Lusaka office, they are distributing 10 kg bags of millimeter to retirees. They are distributing 10 kg bags of millimeter in exchange for NRC numbers, in exchange for voter card numbers, right now as we speak, and they are not allowing any media house to enter there. They have been doing this. They have been giving 12.5 kgs of millimeter, and they ran out of 12.5 kgs of millimeter last week. And so, 2 days ago, they began to give 10 kgs bags of millimeter. As at yesterday, they distributed 200 by 10 kg bags of millimeter and knocked off at 13 hours, while there was still a queue, they asked people to go and come back the following day. Isn't that what they are doing? So when we say that PF is finished, this is what it is. They have to use government apparatus. That office, DMMU, which is under the office of the vice president, now to be used for political gain. DMMU, when they mean to come to mitigate a disaster, or indeed to avert or to support community, they do it publicly and they announce for the sake of transparency and accountability. Right now, where you go there, they lock their offices. No media is allowed. I'm sure the public media are aware, but they were told not to go and cover them because of the illicit conduct of that transaction. Because ordinarily, if that was a proper, you know, a business by DMMU, that should have been headlines on ZNBC, headlines on Times, headlines on Daily Mail. Government comes to the aid of retirees. Those should have been the headlines, because we know how they sound.